Dear students, welcome to e-Shikshana program. In my last class, I considered problems on random variables, both discrete and continuous random variables. In today's class also, I will be continuing my lecture with problems on random variables, mainly continuous random variables. To begin with, let me consider the next problem. The problem is, a function is defined as under f of x is equal to 1 by k in the interval x1 to x2, x1 less than or equal to x, less than or equal to x2, and 0 elsewhere. Find the cumulative distribution of the variate x when k satisfies the requirements for f of x to be a density function. That means, we have to find the value of k for which integral from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1, and then we have to determine the cumulative distribution function, that is CDF, of the random variable x. Okay, let us find the value of k. The value of k comes from this relation. So we know that integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. Our interval is x1 to x2. So this has to be split into three integrals starting from minus infinity to x1 f of x dx plus x1 to x2 f of x dx plus x2 to infinity f of x dx equal to 1. So we know that as per the definition, f of x is 0 in the interval minus infinity to x1, and f of x is also 0 in the interval x2 to infinity, and it is defined only in the interval x1 to x2. So therefore, this integral vanishes and this integral vanishes. So in the interval x1 to x2, f of x is given to be 1 by k. So therefore, integral x1 to x2, 1 by k dx is equal to 1, equated to 1. So 1 by k can be taken outside. 1 by k into integration of dx is x, evaluated at x1 and x2, equated to 1. So this is equal to, when upper limit is and lower limit are substituted, x2 minus x1 divided by k is equal to 1. So therefore, k is equal to x2 minus x1. So this is the value of k, which makes the function f of x probability density function. Next, we shall find the cumulative distribution function. Its definition is, cumulative distribution function f of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to small x is equal to integral minus infinity to x f of x dx. Consider the case A, for any x such that minus infinity less than x less than 1, that is from minus infinity to x1, so in this case, f of x is equal to probability of capital X less than or equal to small x is equal to integral minus infinity to x f of x dx, where x is in this interval minus infinity to x1. In this interval, f of x is equal to 0. So therefore, this integral is 0. Case B, for any x such that x1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to x2. The cumulative distribution function f of x is probability of x less than or equal to x is equal to, by definition, this integral minus infinity to x f of x dx. So this can be written as minus infinity to x1 and x1 to x in this interval. So minus infinity to x1 f of x dx plus x1 to x f of x dx, where x is in this interval. So in this interval, minus infinity to x1, f of x is 0, so therefore integral is 0, plus x1 to x, where x is in this interval, so f of x is defined as 1 by k, so 0 coming from here, plus integral x1 to x, f of x is 1 by k dx, so we take 1 by k outside. If you integrate dx, get x evaluated at x1 and x is equal to x minus x1 divided by k. K is x2 minus x1. case 3, C, for any x such that x is greater than x2 or x2 less than x less than infinity, cumulative distribution function f of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to small x is equal to integral minus infinity to x f of x dx. So this is written as minus infinity to x1 f of x dx plus x1 to x2 f of x dx plus x2 to x where x is greater than x2 or x2 less than x less than infinity f of x dx. So we know that in the interval minus infinity to x1 f of x is 0, so this integral is 0, plus x1 to x2 fx is given to be 1 by k plus away from x1 to x2, x1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to x2, f of x is 0. So here x is greater than x2, so f of x is 0 in this interval, so therefore this integral also vanishes. So we are left with only one integral, x1 to x2. Here f of x is 1 by k integrated with respect to x. So taking 1 by k outside, 1 by k into integral x1 to x2 dx. When we integrate dx, we get x evaluated at x1, x2 will give you x2 minus x1 divided by k. So k is x2 minus x1. So x2 minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. They cancel each other. So we get 1. Thus, the cumulative distribution of the variate x is f of x is equal to 0 in the interval minus infinity less than x less than x1, x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1 in the interval x1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to x2, and it is 1 for x greater than x2 or x2 less than x less than infinity. So this is the cumulative distribution function of the variate capital X. So let me consider another example where we have to find once again cumulative distribution function and also evaluate, find the probability of x greater than or equal to 1.5. The function, the PDF is given to be p of x is equal to x in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, 2 minus x in the interval 1 less than x less than or equal to 2, 0 elsewhere. That means minus infinity to 0, p of x is 0, 2 to infinity, p of x is 0. Away from these two intervals, px is 0. First, let us find the cumulative distribution function of the variate x. So its definition is f of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to x is equal to, by definition, this minus infinity to x, p of x dx. Case A, for any x such that minus infinity less than x less than 0. So f of x is equal to p of x less than or equal to x is equal to minus infinity to x p of x dx. So in this, x lies in this interval. So in this interval, px is 0. So therefore, this integral is 0. F of x is equal to 0. Next, case B. For any x such that 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. So in this case, f of x is equal to p of x less than or equal to x is minus infinity to x p of x dx. So this is split and written as minus infinity to 0 p of x dx plus 0 to x, 0 to x p x dx, where x is in this interval 0 to 1. So we know that minus infinity to 0 p of x is 0, so this integral is 0, plus 0 to x p of x is given to be in the interval 0 to 1 is x, so integral 0 to x p of x is x dx. So if you integrate this, you get x square by 2 evaluated at 0 and x, and you substitute the limits, you get x square by 2. See, for any x such that 1 less than x less than or equal to 2, the next interval. So in this case, f of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to small x is equal to minus infinity to x p of x dx. This is split and written as minus infinity to 0 px dx plus 0 to 1 px dx plus 1 to x px dx. So we know that p of x is 0 in the interval minus infinity to 0, so integral is 0. In the interval 0 to 1, p of x is x, so 0 to 1 x dx, plus in the interval 1, where x is in the interval 1 less than x less than or equal to 2, so in this interval p of x is 2 minus x, so 2 minus x dx. So when you integrate, integration of x square by 2, evaluate it at 0 and 1, plus 2 minus x, if you integrate 2 minus x, 2 minus x whole square divided by 2 into coefficient of x, that is minus 1 minus 2, evaluate it at 1 and x. When you substitute the limits, 1 square by, that is 1 by 2 minus 0, 1 by 2 minus 0, plus when x is x itself, 2 minus x whole square by minus 2, minus the lower limit, and when x is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 square by minus 2, that is 1 by minus 2, so this is plus half and another plus half, that makes 1, 1 plus into minus minus 2 minus x the whole square divided by. So f of x in this case is 1 minus 2 minus x the whole square divided by 2. So lastly, for any x such that x is greater than 2, that is 2 less than x less than infinity, so in this case f of x is equal to p of x less than or equal to x is equal to integral minus infinity to x px dx. So this is written as minus infinity to 0 p of x dx plus 0 to 1 px dx plus 1 to 2 px dx plus 2 to x, where x is greater than 2 or 2 less than x less than infinity px dx. So in this interval minus infinity to 0 px is 0, so this integral is 0. In this interval 0 to 1 px is x, so 0 to 1 x dx, plus in this interval 1 to 2 px is 2 minus x dx plus 2 to infinity, that is x greater than 2, px is 0, so therefore this integral is 0, so 0. Now when integrate x with respect to x square by 2 and evaluate it at 0 and 1, plus integration of 2 minus x whole square by minus 2, evaluate it at 1 and 2. When you substitute the limits, this is 1 square by 2, half minus 0, that is half minus 0, plus when x is 2, 0, 2 minus 2, 0, so 0, minus the lower limit, when x is 1, 2 minus 1, 1 square, 1 by minus 2, 1 by minus 2. So this is minus into minus plus, that is plus half, another plus half is equal to 1. Thus, the cumulative distribution function f of x is 0 in the interval minus infinity less than x less than 0, x square by 2 in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, 1 minus 2 minus x whole square by 2 in the interval 1 less than x less than or equal to 2, and it is 1 when x is greater than 2. The next problem, find the probability of x greater than or equal to 1.5. So we shall take the complement of this. So this is equal to 1 minus p probability of x less than, strictly less than 1.5. So p of x less than or equal to x, by definition of cumulative distribution function, is f of x. P of x less than or equal to x is f of x. So using this, we can write this as 1 minus px less than 1.5 f of 1.5. So 1 minus f of 1.5. See, 1.5 lies in this interval, 1.5. So therefore, substitute x is equal to 1.5 in this. So therefore, 1 minus f of 1.5, 1 minus 2 minus 1.5 whole square divided by 2, So this simplifies to, so this 1 minus 1 will get cancelled, minus into minus plus, 2 minus 1.5 is 0.5, 0.5 whole square by 2, if you so, but divide this by 2, we get 0.125. So probability of x greater than or equal to 1.5 is equal to 0.125. Let me consider the next problem on continuous random variable once again. The problem is, a random variable x has the following density function, probability density function. F of x is equal to k into x square in the interval minus 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 3 and 0 elsewhere. So minus infinity to minus 3 it is 0, 3 to plus infinity f of x is 0. Evaluate k and find probability of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2, 2 probability of x less than or equal to 2 and probability of x greater than 1. So first we shall find out the value of k for which f of x is a density function. So we can find the value of k from this condition. So we know that integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So this has to be split as per the given definition. The f of x is defined only in this interval minus 3 to plus 3. Away from this interval it is 0, that is minus infinity to minus 3 plus integral minus 3 to plus 3 plus integral 3 to infinity. So that is how this has to be resolved. Minus infinity to minus 3 fx dx plus minus 3 to plus 3 f of x dx plus 3 to infinity f of x dx equated to 1. So in this interval minus infinity to minus 3 fx is 0, so this integral is 0. Then similarly 3 to infinity f of x is 0, so this is 0, this integral is 0. So we are left with this integral minus 3 to plus 3 f of x dx. In this interval f of x is given to be k into x square, that we can easily make out. Minus 3 to plus 3 f of x is k into x square. So k into x square dx equated to 1. So k can be taken outside. If you integrate x square, x cube by 3, evaluate it at minus 3 and plus 3 equated to 1. So k into 3 cube by 3 minus 3 cube is minus 3 cube. So minus into minus plus 3 cube by 3. So this makes 3 square plus 3 square. So 9 plus 9, 18. 18k is equal to 1. 18k is equal to 1. Therefore, the value of k is 1 divided by 18. Okay, the next problem. The next question here. Find the probability of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2. So probability of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 is equal to 1 to 2 f of x dx. So 1 to 2 is a part of the subinterval. Subinterval lies within this interval. For all those values, f of x is k into x square only. So 1 to 2 fx is kx square dx. So this is equal to, you can take k outside and integrate x square with respect to x from 1 to 2. So we get x cube by 3 evaluated at 1 and 2. So this is equal to k by 3. 3 I have taken outside here, k by 3. Now only x cube is there, taking 3 outside because it's a constant, 1 by 3 I have taken outside. So k by 3, x cube evaluated at 1 and 2. So 2 cube minus 1. 2 cube is 8, 8 minus 1 is 7, and k is 1 by 18, k is 1 by 18, 7 by 3, this is 7, 8 minus 1, 7, 7 by 3, into k, k is 1 by 18. So this is, when you multiply, this is equal to 7 divided by 7, 1 into 7, 7 divided by 18 into 3, 54. So this is calculated as 0.1296. The next question, probability of x less than or equal to 2. So this can be regarded as probability of minus infinity less than x less than or equal to 2. So this can be written as minus infinity to 2 fx dx, and this is written further as minus infinity to minus 3 fx dx plus minus 3 to 2 minus 3 to 2 fx dx. So in this interval fx is 0, so this integral vanishes, and minus 3 to 2 is also a part of, lies within this, for for this f of x is again kx square minus 3 to 2 kx square dx. So this integral vanishes because fx is equal to 0 in this interval, and only this integral exists in this interval minus 3 to 2 fx is kx square. So integrate kx square with respect to x from minus 3 to plus 2 is equal to k, constant written outside, integration of x square x cube divided by 3 evaluated at minus 3 and plus 2. So I have taken k outside, 1 by 3 outside, so k by 3 into 2 cube minus of minus 3 whole cube. Minus 3 whole cube is minus 3 cube, so minus 2 minus plus 3 cube. So when you simplify, this will be 35 divided by 54. This is calculated as 0.6481. So probability of x less than or equal to 2 is 0.6481. Next problem, probability of x greater than 1. So this can be regarded as probability of 1 less than x less than infinity. So this is equal to 1 to infinity f of x dx. So this further can be split and written as, because our interval, given interval is minus 3 to plus 3 only. So 1 to 3 fx dx plus 3 to infinity fx dx, conveniently we can write using definite integral property. In all the other cases also, same property is being used. So now 3 to infinity f of x is equal to 0. So this integral vanishes. So you are left with only the first integral, 1 to 3. In 1 to 3, f of x is given to be k into x square. So integrate k into x square with respect to x from 1 to 3. So k into integration of x square, x cube by 3, evaluated at 1 and 3. This is equal to, here also I have taken 1 by 3 outside, k by 3 into 3 cube, when x is 3, upper limit is substituted, 3 cube minus the lower limit, x is equal to 1, that is 1 cube. So 3 cube, 27 minus 1, that is 26, 26, and this is k is 1 by 18, 1 by 18 into 3, 1 by 54 into 26, and when we simplify, we get 13 by 27 is equal to 0.4814. So probability of x strictly greater than 1 is 0.4814. Let me consider another problem on continuous random variable. The problem is, the probability density function of a continuous random variable x is f of x is equal to k into x into 1 minus x e power x in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1 and elsewhere 0 and 0 elsewhere. Find the value of k and evaluate the mean and the standard deviation of x. So to find the standard deviation, we should know variance. So first we have to find the variance of x and then standard deviation of x. So we have to find the value of k assuming that f of x integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. That is the solution part. So to find the value of k, we know that integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So this is again is resolved into sum of three integrals, minus infinity to 0, 0 to 1, plus 1 to infinity. So minus infinity to 0 fx dx plus 0 to 1 fx dx, 1 to infinity fx dx is equal to 1. In this interval, minus infinity to 0, fx is 0, so this integral vanishes. Here also, fx is 0, so this integral vanishes. So we are left with the middle integral, 0 to 1. So here, f of x is given to be k into x into 1 minus x e power x. So k into x, 1 minus x e power x dx equated to 1. So as usual, we take constant outside k, integral 0 to 1, multiply x to 1 minus x square into e power x dx is equated to 1. So here we have to integrate by parts. Let us use general rule of integration by parts as we did in the last class, and also I explained the formula and also considered one or two examples how to use general rule of integration by parts in cases like this. So let us use the same formula, general rule of integration by parts. So we consider this as the first function u and this as the second function v. Okay, so k into big bracket first function x minus x square into v1, that is u v1. So v1 means integration of v once. So x minus x square first function integration of second function e power x is e power x itself, then alternate sign. So we started with plus sign, now minus, differentiation of x minus x square, that is 1 minus 2x into integration of this, that is v2, integration of e power x is e power x only, next minus plus differentiation of 1 minus 2x, so 0 minus 2, that is minus 2, into integration of e power x integration is e power x only. So there ends there it gets terminated, because u dash is 1 minus 2x, u double dash is minus 2, and further derivatives are 0. So therefore other terms will not exist. It gets terminated here. So we stop here and evaluate at 0 and 1. When x is 1, 1 minus 1, 0. So you get 0 here. When x is 1, 1 minus 2, minus 1 into minus, that is plus 1, plus 1 into e, plus e. When x is 1, minus 2 into e, minus 2e, minus the lower limit. When x is 0, because x is in both the terms, so this is 0, minus. When x is 0, minus 1 into e power 0 is 1, so minus 1. Then when x is 0, e power 0 is 1, so minus 2. So when you simplify, this is k into e minus 2e minus e, minus 1 minus 1 minus 3 into minus 1, that is plus 3. So 3 minus e into k is equal to 1. Therefore, k is 1 divided by 3 minus e. Next, we shall consider mean. Mean e of x. Its definition is integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx, x into f of x dx. So x is missing here. The mean e of x is integral minus infinity to plus infinity x into fx dx. So again, this has to be split into minus infinity to 0, 0 to 1, plus 1 to infinity. So minus infinity to 0 integral is 0. Then similarly, 1 to infinity integral also is 0. So get the middle integral 0 to 1. In this interval, f of x is given to be k into x 1 minus x e power x, that is x into this x into k x 1 minus x e power x dx. So we take k outside and multiply x into x square to 1 minus x, so you get x square minus x cube, x into x square into 1 x square minus x square into x cube e power x dx. So we integrate this again by parts using general rule of integration by parts. So we keep k outside, so begin to into bracket, first function is x square minus x cube, so x square minus x cube integration of e power x minus differentiation of x square minus x cube, that is 2x minus 3x square integration of e power x minus, that is minus, the alternate sign plus, differentiation of this 2 minus 6x into integration of e power x only, plus here, next is minus, differentiation of 2 minus 6x, that is minus 6, into integration of e power x, the evaluated, and this gets terminated here because u dash, u double dash, u triple dash is constants, so further terms are all constant because derivative u triple dash is constant, the fourth derivative, fifth derivative are all zero, so none of the terms exist and it gets terminated here, so this is evaluated at 0 and 1. Now put the upper limit minus the lower limit. When x is substituted, x is equal to 1, 1 minus 1, 0, so 0. When x is 1, 2 minus 3, that is minus 1, that is plus e power 1, that is plus e. When x is 1, 2 minus 3, that is minus 4 into e, minus 4e, minus, when x is 1, minus into minus, that is plus 6 into e, plus 6e, minus the lower limit, minus the lower limit, when x is 0, so this term is 0, 0, when x is 0, this term is also 0, 0, when x is 0, 2 into e power 0 is 1, so 2, when x is 0, minus 6 into minus 1, that is plus 6. So if you simplify, this will be 7e minus 4e, that is 3e, minus 8, 2 plus 6 is 8, so minus 8 is equal to 3e minus 8, the k is 1 by 3 minus e, k is 1 by 3 minus e, that's what we obtained, k is 1 by 3 minus e, so that should be written here, k is 1 by 3 minus e, so therefore 3e minus 8 divided by 3 minus e, so if you simplify, you get the value 0.5496. Next, to find standard deviation, this is the question asked here, so we need to find variance first. So variance sigma square is given to be e of x square minus e of x the whole square. So very easy to remember, variance is e x square minus e x the whole square. So e of x is our mean, this has been already done, so e of x is 0.5496. So we need to find only e of x square and then compute this variance. So e of x square is minus infinity to plus infinity x square fx dx. Again, we have to split this into minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to 1 plus 1 to infinity. So the first and the third integral, for the reasons discussed in the previous cases, 0. So therefore, you get only the middle integral, that is from 0 to 1, x square f of x dx. So in this interval 0 to 1, f of x is given to be k into x 1 minus x into e power x dx. So let us multiply x square and x to 1 minus x. So we write k outside the integral, k into 0 to 1, x square into x cube, multiply to 1 minus x, that is x cube minus x power 4 e power x dx. So let us integrate this by using general rule of integration by parts. In that case, we consider this as the first function u and this as the second function v. So k into big bracket, first function x cube minus x power 4 into integration of e power x, e power x minus differentiation of x cube minus x power 4, 3x square minus 4x cube into integration of e power x is e power x plus alternate sign minus plus differentiation of this term, that is 6x minus 12x square into integration of e power x only, the plus next is minus differentiation of 6x minus 12x square is 6 minus 24x into integration of e power x, that is e power x only, plus next is plus minus, now it is plus differentiation of 6 minus 24 is minus 24, integration of e power x is e power x only, so it gets terminated here because this is constant, this is evaluated at 0 and 1. When upper limit is substituted, so this is k into 1 minus 1 0 0 and here when x is 1, 3 minus 4 minus 1 into minus, that is plus e, plus e, when x is 1, 6 minus 12 minus 6 e power 1, that is e, and here 6 minus 24 minus 18 into minus 1, that is plus 18 e, then minus 24e minus the lower limit, when x is 0, this term is 0, this term is 0, this term is also 0, so 0 minus 0 plus 0, and only get terms from this term, quantities from this term, when x is 0, 6 into e power 0, that is 1, that is 6 multiplied by minus sign, so minus 6, and here when x is 0, 1 minus 24, so minus 24, this is minus 30, so plus 30, plus 30, and this will be simplified to minus 11e, so this is equal to 30 minus 11e divided by 3 minus e, because k is 1 by 3 minus e, so when you simplify this will be 0.3510, so e of x square is 0.3510. Now let us substitute in the formula of variance. So variance sigma square is equal to e of x square 0.3510 minus e of x the whole square. So e of x is mean. So mean is 0.5496. So minus 0.5496 whole square. So when you simplify this, you get 0.0489. So this is the variance. Standard deviation sigma is square root of variance. So variance is 0.0489. So root of that is 0.2212. So standard deviation is equal to 0.2212. The next question on continuous random variable. A continuous random variable x as a probability density function, f of x is equal to 3x square in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. Find a and b such that probability of x less than or equal to a is equal to probability of x greater than a, and probability of x greater than b is equal to 0.05. So here the question is, we have to find the value of a for which this is balanced, and value of b for which this is balanced. Okay, now this is like two probabilities, p of x less than or equal to a and p of x greater than a, both are equal, so both must be equal to half, therefore because sum of the probabilities is 1, that's what is given here. Since probability of x less than or equal to a is equal to probability of x greater than a, each must be equal to half, because total probability is equal to 1, because they are same, they are equal. So you can consider either this or this to calculate the value of a. Now let us consider probability of x less than or equal to a is equal to half. The same value of a you will get even if you consider probability of x greater than a is equal to half, and continue the calculation. So let us consider probability of x less than or equal to a is equal to half. That is, probability of x less than or equal to a is 0 to a, because our interval is given to be 0 to 1, start from 0 to 1. So 0 to a, that means this is minus infinity less than x less than or equal to a. So we have to split actually this into minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to a. So minus infinity to 0, f of x is 0. So thus integral vanishes. So therefore we get 0 to a f of x dx is equal to half. So in this interval, f of x is 3x square dx. So integral 0 to a 3x square dx is equal to half. That is 3 into integration of x square, x cube by 3, evaluated at 0 and a equal to half. So 3, 3 can cancel, or 3 times a cube by 3 minus 0 is equal to half. So 3, 3 can cancel. So this gives a cube is equal to half. Therefore, a is equal to cube root of 1 by 2 or 1 by 2 to the power 1 by 3. If you calculate this, you get 0.79. So the value of a is 0.79. The same value of a you will get when you consider p of x greater than a and continue the calculations. Next question. Find the value of b so that probability of x greater than b is equal to 0.05. So that is, this can be regarded as b less than x less than infinity. So our interval is up to 1 only. So this can be written as b to 1 plus 1 to infinity. In the interval 1 to infinity, f of x is equal to 0. So that integral vanishes. So that is how we get integral b to 1 f of x dx. This is equated to, this is given to be 0.05. So in this interval b to 1, f of x is 3x square. So 3x square dx is equal to 0.05. So when you integrate, taking 3 outside, 3 into integration of x square, x cube by 3, evaluated at b and 1, equal to 0.05. So 3, 3 can cancel, or 3 into 1 by 3 minus b cube by 3 is equal to 0.05. So you can cancel this 3, 3. So 1 minus b cube is equal to 0.05, or b cube is 1 minus 0.05. So b cube is equal to, so 1 minus 0.05 is 0.95. So therefore b is 0.98. Our next question. A random variable x has the density function f of x is equal to k divided by 1 plus x square in the interval minus infinity less than x less than infinity. Determine k and evaluate p of x greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so we have to find the value of k. The value of k again comes from the relation integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So we know that integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So therefore minus infinity to plus infinity, so here it is defined as k by 1 plus x square. So minus infinity to plus infinity k by 1 plus x square dx is equal to 1, equated to 1. So k, we take it outside. Integration of 1 by 1 plus x square is tan inverse x, evaluated at minus infinity and plus infinity, equated to 1. So k into tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse of minus infinity upper limit. When upper limit is substituted, tan inverse of infinity minus, when lower limit is substituted, tan inverse of minus infinity is equated to 1. So k into tan inverse of infinity is pi by 2. tan inverse of minus infinity is minus pi by 2. So minus into minus plus plus pi by 2. So this makes 2 pi by 2 r pi. K pi is equal to 1. Therefore k is equal to 1 divided by pi. Therefore the value of k is 1 by pi. Next question. Probability of x greater than or equal to 0. So this can be regarded as written as probability of 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity. Less than infinity. So this is equal to 0 to infinity f of x dx. So 0 to infinity, it is given to be k divided by 1 plus x square dx. F of x is k divided by 1 plus x square. So this is equal to k outside you can take. So value of k is 1 by pi. Integration of 1 by 1 plus x square is tan inverse x evaluated at 0 and infinity. So this is equal to 1 by pi into tan inverse of infinity is pi by 2 minus tan inverse of 0 is 0. So pi pi will get cancelled. So I get half. The next function, next problem. Is the function f of x is equal to e power minus x 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity in the interval e power minus x in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity and 0 elsewhere. Fx is e power minus x in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity and 0 elsewhere. Is this function a density function? Probability density function of a continuous random variable x. So we need to check two points. F of x is greater than or equal to 0 for all x and integral from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. If so, if it is a probability density function, determine one less than probability of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 and also find the cumulative distribution function f of x and evaluate f of 2. This is the question. So first we shall find out whether this f of x is a probability density function. If it is probability density function, then we determine this probability and find the cumulative distribution function and evaluate f of 2. So clearly we can easily make out, give any value of x here, f of x is always greater than or equal to 0. So clearly f of x is greater than or equal to 0 and integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is can be written as minus infinity to 0 f of x dx plus 0 to infinity. So minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to infinity. So in this interval, minus infinity to 0, minus 0 elsewhere, minus infinity to 0, f of x is 0. So this integral vanishes. So we are left with the integral 0 to infinity f of x dx. In this interval, f of x is e power minus x, e power minus x. So 0 to infinity e power minus x dx. So integration of e power minus x is e power minus x by minus 1 evaluated at 0 and infinity. So this is equal to when x is infinity, e power minus infinity is 0 minus when x is 0, e power 0 is 1, 1 by minus 1 is minus 1, so minus 1. So this is minus into minus plus 1. So integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1 and also f of x is greater than or equal to 0. See, both the conditions are satisfied. Therefore f of x is a probability density function. Next question is find the probability of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2. So this is equal to 1 to 2 f of x dx. So 1 to 2 in this interval, f of x is e power minus x. So integral 1 to 2 e power minus x dx. This is equal to integration of e power minus x is minus e power minus x evaluated at 1 and 2. So this is equal to when x is 2 minus e power minus 2 minus the lower limit minus e power minus 1. So when you simplify, this is plus e power minus 1 minus e power minus 2. So 1 by e minus 1 by e square. When we calculate, we get 0.2325. So probability of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 is 0.2325. Now let us find the cumulative distribution function. So this is the definition of cumulative distribution function for a continuous random variable. So let us consider a case A. For any x such that minus infinity less than x less than 0. So f of x is probability of x less than or equal to small x is equal to integral minus infinity to x f of x dx. So in this interval, x is in this interval minus infinity to 0. So here f of x is equal to 0. Therefore, this integral is 0. Case B. For any x such that 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity, for which the cumulative distribution function f of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to small x is equal to minus infinity to x f of x dx. So this is equal to minus infinity to 0 f of x dx plus 0 to x, where x is in this interval 0 to infinity. So in the interval minus infinity to 0, f of x is 0. So therefore integral is 0 plus 0 to x, where x is in this interval 0 to infinity, for which f of x is e power minus x. So 0 to x e power minus x dx. This is equal to integration of e power minus x is minus e power minus x evaluated at 0 and x. When x is x itself, so minus e power minus x minus of when x is 0 minus 1. So minus 1. So this makes 1 plus 1 minus e power minus x. So 1 minus e power minus x. Thus, the cumulative distribution function is f of x is equal to 0 in the interval minus infinity less than x less than 0. And it is 1 minus e power minus x in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity. So to find the value of fx at x is equal to 2, so 2 lies in this interval, so we make a substitution x is equal to 2 in this function 1 minus e power minus x. So f of 2 is equal to 1 minus e power minus 2 that is equal to 1 minus 1 by e square, or when we simplify with the use of calculator, we get 0.86. Okay, problem number 14. If a continuous random variable x has probability density function f of x is equal to 1 by 4 in the interval minus 2 less than x less than 2 and 0 elsewhere, obtain probability of x less than 1, probability of mod x greater than 1, and probability of 2x plus 3 greater than 5. So probability of x less than 1, that is probability of minus infinity less than x less than 1. So this will be, so it is given that fx is 1 by 4 in this interval minus 2 to plus 2, minus 2 to plus 2, fx is 1 by 4 away from this interval minus infinity to minus 2, 0, 2 to infinity is also 0. So using this definition, this can be split and written as, so this is 1, so we shall make correction here. It's taking some time, but this has to be 1. minus infinity to 1, and that should be split like this. Minus infinity to plus 1 f of x dx. Now this should be split as minus infinity to minus 2 and minus 2 to plus 1. Minus 2 to plus 1 f of x dx. So in this interval, minus infinity to 2 minus infinity to minus 2 is 0. F of x is 0. So this integral vanishes, plus minus 2 to plus 1 f of x dx. In this interval, f of x is 1 by 4 into dx. So 1 by 4 is constant. We can write outside. Integration of dx is x. Evaluate it at minus 2 and 1. That will give you 1 by 4 into 1 minus half minus 2. That is 1 plus 2, 3. 3 by 4. Okay, so next problem. Probability of mod x greater than 1. So this can be written as 1 minus probability of mod x less than or equal to 1, the complement of this 1 minus probability of mod x less than or equal to 1. So this further can be written as 1 minus probability of minus 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, and this is equal to 1 minus integral from minus 1 to plus 1 of 1 by 4 dx. In this integral, minus 1 to plus 1 f of x is 1 by 4. So 1 minus 1 by 4 integration of x dx x evaluated at minus 1 and plus 1. So this is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4, 1 minus of minus 1, that is plus 2. So 1 minus 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2, 1 minus half is plus half. Okay, next question, probability of 2x plus 3 greater than 5. So this is equal to, we have to simplify, solve for capital X. So this can be simplified as 2x greater than 5 minus 3, that is 2, and divide by 2. So probability of x greater than 1, this can be regarded as probability of 1 less than x less than infinity, that is 1 to infinity. So integral from 1 to infinity f of x dx, 1 to infinity can be split and written as 1 to 2 f of x dx plus 2 to infinity f of x dx. So away from this interval 2 to infinity f of x is 0. So 2 to infinity, so this integral vanishes. So we are left with only this integral, integral from 1 to 2, here f of x is given to be 1 by 4. F of x is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 dx. So 1 by 4 integration of dx x evaluated at 1 and 2. So this will be 1 by 4 into 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. So 1 by 4 or 0.25. Next question. A continuous random variable x has probability density function given by 2 into e power minus 2x when x is greater than 0 and 0 when x is less than or equal to 0. Less than or equal to 0. Evaluate the mean e of x and e of x square. Hence find the standard deviation. Okay. So first we shall find the mean e of x. So mean e of x is defined as integral minus infinity to plus infinity x f x dx. So this has to be split as per the definition of given f of x. Fx is twice e power minus 2x in the range 0 less than x less than infinity, and elsewhere it is 0, that is minus infinity less than x less than or equal to 0. Okay. So minus infinity to 0 x fx dx plus 0 to infinity x fx dx. So minus infinity to 0, fx is 0. So this integral vanishes. So therefore, this is equal to x into f of x. So here f of x is 2 into e power minus 2x. So 2 into x into this 2 I have taken outside. So x into 2 e power minus 2x dx. So this 2 I have taken outside. Now we have to integrate by parts. We have to integrate this by parts, taking x as the first function, e power minus 2x as the second function. So 2 times first function x into integration of e power minus 2x, e power minus 2x by minus 2 minus differentiation of x is 1 into integration of this e power minus 2x by minus 2 into minus 2, that is plus 4, evaluated at 0 and infinity. When x is infinity, e power minus infinity is 0. So therefore we get this is 0. So 2 into, when upper limit is substituted, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus the lower limit, when x is 0, this term is 0, minus when x is 0, this is 1 by 4. 1 by 4. So this is okay. So when you simplify, you get 1 by 2. E of x square. We need to find E of x square first and then the variance. E of x square is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x square into f of x dx. This is equal to integral minus infinity to 0 x square f x dx plus integral 0 to infinity x square f x dx. So in this interval, f of x is equal to 0. So therefore, we get x square 0 to infinity x square 2 into e power minus 2x dx. So we get twice 0 to infinity x square e power minus 2x dx. So this is equal to 2 into, again we have to integrate this by parts, x square is the first function, into integration of second function e power minus 2x by minus 2 minus differentiation of x square 2x into integration of this term e power minus 2x by plus 4, minus 2 into minus 4, minus 2 plus 4, plus differentiation of 2x 2 into integration of this e power minus 2x divided by 4 into minus 2, that is minus 8, and this gets terminated here. So this has to be evaluated at 0 and infinity. So this is equal to 2 into, when x is infinity, e power minus infinity is 0, 0, 0, so the contribution is 0, minus the lower limit, when x is 0, this term is 0, 0, this term is also 0, 0, then here, when x is 0, 2 into 1 by minus 8, 1 by minus 8, so if you simplify carefully, you get e of x square is equal to 1 by 2. So variance sigma square is ex square minus ex the whole square. So 1 by 2 and the mean is 1 by 2 again. So e of x square is 1 by 2. E of x is 1 by 2 the whole square. So 1 by 4. 1 by 4. So if you simplify, this is plus 1 by 4. So standard deviation is square root of variance. So this is equal to 1 by 2. So standard deviation is 1 by 2. Okay. Next question. The probability density function of a random variable capital X is f of x is equal to k into x square in the interval 0 less than x less than 3 and elsewhere 0 or 0 otherwise. So find the value of k. The first question, second question, probability of, find the probability of 1 less than x less than 2, and third problem, find the probability of p of x, probability of x less than or equal to 1. So we get the value of k from the condition integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So we split this as per the given definition, minus infinity to 0, so our interval is 0 to 3, so minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to 3 plus 3 to infinity. So minus infinity to 0 fx dx plus 0 to 3 fx dx plus 3 to infinity fx dx. in this interval 3 to infinity fx is 0, so this vanishes. In this interval fx is 0, so this vanishes. So we are left with only the second integral, where f of x is defined to be kx square. So 0 to 3 kx square dx equated to 1. So we take k outside, integrate x square with respect to x, x cube by 3 evaluated at 0 and 3 equated to 1. So this is k into 3 cube by 3 minus 0 is equal to 1. 3 cube by 3 is 3 square, so 9k is equal to 1. So value of k is 1 by 9. Next, probability of 1 less than x less than 2. So straight away we can write integral 1 to 2 kx square dx. So we take k outside, integrate x square with respect to x from 1 to 2. When we do so, we get k into x cube by 3 evaluated at 1 and 2. So this is equal to k times 2 cube by 3 minus 1 cube by 3. So this is equal to k is 1 by 9 into 8 minus 1, 7 by 3. So this will be 0.2592 if you simplify. Next problem. Probability of x less than or equal to 1 can be regarded as probability of minus infinity less than x less than or equal to 1. So therefore, you can straight away write with that understanding integral minus infinity to 1 f of x dx. This again we have to split as per the given definition. Minus infinity to 0, 0 to that value. Minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to 1 f of x dx. In this interval, fx is 0, so this integral vanishes. In this interval, f of x is k into x square, so 0 to 1 kx square. So we take k outside, integrate x square with respect to x, that is x cube by 3, evaluate it at 0 and 1. So if you substitute the limits, k into 1 by 3 minus 0, so k is 1 by 9 into 1 by 3, so 1 by 27. If you simplify, it is, the value is 0.037. Okay, so this is a discrete problem on discrete random variable. Very interesting problem. The problem is from a urn containing 3 red and 2 white balls, a man is to draw 2 balls at random without replacement, being promised rupees 20 for each red ball he draws and rupees 10 for each white ball he draws, that is white one. Find his expectation, so find the average. The problem is from an urn containing 3 red and 2 white balls, a man is to draw 2 balls at random without replacement, being promised rupees 20 for each red ball he draws and rupees 10 for each white one. Find the expectation, find the average expected. The man expects average money, rupees he expects. So now urn contains 3 red, 2 white balls, so totally there are 5 balls in the urn. So 2 balls if we draw at random, there are 3 possibilities. Both red can come, 2 red can come, or 1 red, 1 white can come, or only 2 white can come, like 2 reds coming. So there are 3 possibilities. 2 red, 1 white, and 2 white. So if he draws 2 red, he earns rupees 40. If he draws 1 red and 1 white, he earns rupees 20 plus 10, 30. If he draws only 2 white balls, he gets rupees 10 plus 10, 20 rupees. So if we define the random variable, denote the number of red and white balls drawn, then x can take the values. How it can take the values? If he draws 2 red, 40 rupees. If he draw 1 red, 1 white, 30 rupees. if we draw both white balls, 20 rupees. So x can take the values 40, 30, 20 or 20, 30, 40 in whatever manner we write, doesn't matter. Under what probability this 40 is earning, under what probability this is happening, under what probability this is happening is the question now. Now when x is 40, that is coming when he draws two red balls. So probability of two red balls. So two red balls should come from three red balls only. That is the favorable number of cases of drawing red balls. So that can happen in 3C2 ways, and we have 5 balls in that urn. So 2 balls can be drawn in 5C2 ways. That is the exhaust number of cases. Therefore, its probability is 3C2 by 5C2. That makes 2. 3 divided by 10. Okay. When x is 30, 30 happens when he draws 1 red and 1 white. So probability of drawing 1 red and 1 white ball. So 1 red can come from 3 in 3C1 ways, and 1 white can come out of 2 white balls in 2C1 ways. So the favorable number of cases is 3C1 into 2C1 for this event to happen. Exhaust number of cases is 5C2. So therefore the probability of 1 red 1 white ball is 6 by 10. Similarly, when x is for x 20, that is probability of drawing 2 white balls. So P of 2 white balls. So there are 2 white balls in that urn. So 2 can be drawn only 2C2, that is 1. 2C2 ways, only one way. Exhaust number of cases is 5C2. So 1 divided by 10. So we shall write the probability distribution. X taking the value 40, 30, 20. So corresponding probabilities P of 40. That is 2 red balls, 3 by 10, 1 red ball, 1 white ball, 6 by 10, 2 white balls, 1 by 10. So expectation E of x is x into sigma x into px, that is 40 into 3 by 10 plus 30 into 6 by 10 plus 20 into 1 by 10. So you can easily see 3 plus 6 plus 1 makes the 10, 10 by 10 is 1. So total probability is 1. So expectation is 40 into 3 by 10 plus 30 into 6 by 10 plus 20 into 1 by 10. So when you simplify, we get 32. So his expectation is rupees 32. So I'm going to stop here. I have completed this random variables chapter. Next class, I will take up probability distributions, that is discrete probability distributions. Thank you.